I want to make a little platform I can place a camera on that I can easily tilt it and such to orient the camera. And I figured the simplest way for this would actually be just to have some kind of a ball and socket joint, because that goes in any direction. But I don't actually even need a socket, because any sort of circular rim would already suffice as the socket to be able to orient it in any direction. But a ball is rather tricky to make, but I don't even need a whole ball, because if I have a rim, basically just a cylinder would already work like a ball in that I can orient it in any direction just fine. But if my cylinder is the right size, I can essentially just put the camera inside of it. And the nice thing about that is it's nicely balanced in that it won't want to tip one way or another. And I don't even need this to be a whole cylinder. All I need is just to have a fraction of a cylinder like that, because if with this way, the camera can't see anything anyways. So maybe just something like this, with the camera on there, and I can tilt it this way and that way, except the camera wants to slide off. Now I could screw the camera by the tripod mount to this so keep it from sliding off, or I could just put a couple of pegs in this thing, and this thing can now be aimed up, or if I put the camera on the other way around, it can be aimed down, and I can go this way, and I can tilt it this way and that way. Figuring out how to get the best dimensions of this thing and how to make it is tricky, and I've just been iterating by cutting out pieces of wood. This is the base for it, until I'm pretty happy with it. And I think I'm pretty close now. And I started by cutting the bevels on the edges of these things on the bandsaw freehand like that, which I knew was kind of hair-raising, and it did get away on me one time and kinked the blade pretty badly. That's this blade here. And I managed to fix that blade by first kind of just grabbing it and bending the kinks that I could see out of it, and then forcing it to bend back and forth while it ran, by forcing something against here and against here, which essentially is pulling the blade through a bit of a kink, and that essentially made it all bent consistently and got that kink that I put into it basically pretty much gone. And I've been refining the dimensions for what works best, and this is what I've got now. And rather than cutting them out of one workpiece, I essentially start with a block of wood that contains two workpieces. And I cut that out and cut all the bevels on it, and I don't split it into two until the very end, so I have a good chunk of wood to hold it by. And since this is intended to be a gift, I'm going to make some more out of a nice piece of ash. And my starting blank needs to be 70 by 72 millimeters. And my piece of wood is just big enough to cut out two of those double blanks. And the first thing I'm going to mark is the radius for the overall extent of the pieces. And next, I mark where my bevel cut is going to go to. And another smaller arc for where I sand to. And I also mark that on the other side, and it's important that those two are aligned with each other, otherwise the whole thing is going to be a bit skewed. And now I can cut that out on the bandsaw, and this cut isn't tricky yet. Now you do need a very sharp quarter-inch blade for this kind of cut in hardwood, otherwise it'll go all squirrely on you. And then tilting the table to 20 degrees. Now working with a big blank like that is a lot safer than working with a little one, but it's still a bit hairy. So I've got a safety contraption here, which consists of this piece of wood that goes on here like so, and that way if it does kind of catch on there, it can't go very far. And this is now still a freehand cut, but a lot safer. And checking this with a circle, we can see it hits just on the corner, so I'm going to bevel that a bit more to make that edge like part of a sphere. And that fits really nicely into a circle now. And it doesn't have to be that diameter of circle. Basically, this is like part of a sphere, so a smaller circle or a slightly larger one will work too. And having sanded off my bandsaw cut marks, I can now cut it down the middle. And this is the base I made so far. Fits nicely, but it doesn't need to be quite as thick, so I'm going to use this Baltic birch, which is also much nicer because this is going to be a gift. And it doesn't need to be as thick as what I had. The inside of this circle is 38 millimeters in radius, and it's 12 millimeters thick, which is just deep enough that this doesn't hit by a few millimeters. Now I need to locate the pins that keep the camera from sliding off. And as long as the camera's center of mass is about the center of our sphere, this thing will be perfectly stable in any orientation, aiming up or aiming down with the pegs on the downward side so the camera doesn't slide down. And because I made a whole bunch, I also made this one, which is for this phone-like thermal camera, which can tilt down this way or tilt up. And I also tried one for my big DSLR, which getting the balance right for that one is a bit tricky because the camera is a bit top-heavy on that thing. So I'd really need to make a bigger one if I wanted to use it with the DSLR. And if you want to make your own one of these, here's the final dimensions that I ended up using. So I think overall, this gadget takes the role of what little tripods like this one, or even like this tiny one, take. But this one is much more informal and you just place the camera on there, no need to screw it on. But chances are, when you really do have a use for it, you probably forget that you have it and then just prop it up on a book or something else. But in the meantime, it is, I think, a potentially very useful gadget, and it makes a great sort of Christmas present, stocking stuffer type of thing, because this didn't take very much time to make once I figured out how to make it. And so I made a whole bunch.